Like the intro says, welcome to my channel and welcome to my workshop here in Costa Blanca, Spain. On my last video, I made a tea light with a candle inside, or electric one, battery operated candle inside, that inspired me to try and take it a little bit further and make something slightly different but bigger for this video. What I decided to make was a copy of a Davy lamp, which was a lamp invented by Free Davy to make it safer for miners in the mines. It gave them light, but it also gave them a warning that there was inflammable gases around them in the mine, and to take care and to take precautions because of that. The things I needed for it, I've got a very nice piece of olive that I can make it out of. I needed a glass to make the glass piece between the top and bottom, which I bought an ordinary drinking glass, scribed it around the centre with a glass cutter, and then run it under alternately warm and cold water until it just broke apart. And that gives me the cylinder that I needed for the centre part of the lamp. Other things I bought to save me some work was some 5mm dowel, which is some supports that go around the glass section. You'll see that when it comes up later in the video. Beyond that, it was just the tea light, which are really cheap and cheerful. €1.25 for two of them, including the batteries, and they work very well. So let's get on with making the thing now and load the olive oil into the between centres. I'll put a tenon on one end. And we'll see how it goes from there. Right, it's loaded it between centres, and with a spindle roofing gouge, I'll take it down to round. I need to get about 3 inches, 75mm diameter out of it. So minimum size, I think, should be able to get it. Right, let's turn it to round. We have still a very little flat spot here, but I'm sure we can accommodate that in the turning of the rest of the lamp. So it never ceases to amaze me the beauty in these pieces of olive wood. It's incredible. look at that grain. Anyway, next thing is to start to put a tenon on this end, if this is going to be the top of the lamp, so that we can hold it to produce the bit where the glass is in the centre. I've got more than enough here for the dimensions that I'm working to. Then I'll put it, face this end off, part it off, but leaving a tenon to hold so that I can turn that in the same direction of the grain. A little tip when you're producing a tenon on the chuck end, when you've got a drive centre, if you eye the diameter of your tenon compared with the inside diameter of your chuck jaws, which are currently gripped on the centre, it's an easy way, saves a lot of measuring, of getting the diameter of your tenon the same as the diameter of the inside of your jaws. The drawing says we've got 100mm between the top end of the lantern and the bottom end where it meets the glass, so I'm going to give myself a little bit of extra space because I have plenty of timber here, and take it to 110mm. Where I'll start to part it off there on that mark, and then before it's fully parted off, produce a tenon for this end of the piece, the bottom end of the piece, so I don't have to turn it round and do a double tenon, if that makes sense. Right, having faced it off, we next need to make a hole down the centre, just really for to produce it, to make it lighter, which eventually we'll be opening up to take the piece of glass for the lens, but we don't need to take that out to the same diameter. So although that's very sharp, it'll be buried and glued in place, so there won't be any danger from that. That's the next point. Right now we need to produce the taper. This is the area that holds on the real lantern, would hold the mesh filament that stops the explosive gases getting to the flame. So that's about the right size, I think, for the real thing. So let's take this down. We've got a taper on there going to reduce it at the top end. And a step here. We've also got to drill some holes around here to take the supports that go around the glass, fixing it to the base. Taper here needs to be 55 mil at this end and 50 mil at that end, giving the very gentle taper.
Thank you.
Thank you. I drew myself a little template. I wanted 5 holes equally spaced around the rim. Copied that on the. I'll be copying that on the top section of the lamp as well. Marked off the 5 equally spaced markings. Not a very good drawing, but it worked for me. Marked them on the edges of the base of the lamp, and then copied them through to the area where I want to drill them. I've dimpled it so that it should take the drill all right. The drill I've got is one of the pointed ones, can't think what they're called at the moment, wood drills, and I've marked it off so that I can only go to a certain depth because I don't want to break through. I want it to leave the other side intact. I don't want to break through there. So now I'll make sure that I drill them vertical. I'll be drilling the 5 holes. I obviously want to line the grains up as much as possible. It's not far out there, and get it as concentric with the other piece as possible. Clamp that in place, and then just mark off where I had the original markings for the other 5 holes. Mark those off with a pencil. Having got them marked off, I can now separate this and mark on the inside face where I've had the pencil lines. That should line them up with the bottom section. Not critical, but the closer it is, the better it'll look. I've dimpled the other face now to match the one that I've just done, and using the same drill, same settings, gonna drill the holes. There we have the 5 holes drilled in the same locations as the bottom section. Next thing we need to do is to calculate the length that we need these rods to be. In the finished article, that will be in position in there. That will be in position in there. Now I need to mark off how long these rods need to be. I'll guess something like that, which I'll cut one and then try it out. Easiest way to cut these is just by pressing straight down with a Stanley knife, rolling it slightly. Like so. That feels just about spot on, I would have thought. So if I cut another four of those, you can get the idea as to how they're positioned around the outside. And then we'll glue those and epoxy the glass in place, and we're almost there. The next thing is to mix a bit of 5-minute epoxy to glue the glass in place. We'll use a two-part mixture. Never know how to seal these off afterwards. Usually put a nail or something in the hole. Right, mix the epoxy. It's nice and secure and as square as I can get it. Then some wood glue into the holes for the pillars. Press them into place. Finally, wood glue in the epoxy into the rim of the base. Obviously cleaned off all the glass and all the surfaces in the, going to be inside before I started doing the gluing, to make sure that, because we're not going to be able to get to them afterwards. Line up the grains. Wipe off the excess glue. Right, so there we have the finished article. Quite pleased with that, it looks quite nice. Done a couple of little bits off camera. The tea light was a little bit of a loose fit in there. Wants to stay in place, so I've wrapped a bit of white insulating tape around it. Could be done with a couple of spots of hot glue, just to hold it in space. So if they ever need to change it, you only need to cut the hot glue and take the lamp out. With it working, looks quite nice, the flickering effect, And the other thing I did was just to take the top piece down on the sides so that it can take a ring or a hook to that would have had to have hung something like this. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please put a like on there. If you haven't subscribed, I'd appreciate you subscribing. And other than that, see you on the next video. Bye.